Today I'd like to demonstrate a technique for assessing a patient for relative afferent pupillary defect. In simple terms, testing for an RAPD demonstrates if there is a difference in the amount of light that each optic nerve conducts to the midbrain. In other words, it assesses the health of one optic nerve relative to another, and it does so by comparing how both pupils react to the swinging flashlight test. To assess for an RAPD, the swinging flashlight test is employed, where the bright source of light is moved fairly quickly back and forth between the pupils to evaluate and compare their reaction to light. First, dim the lights in the room and ask the patient to look into the distance. Use a bright source of light. I prefer a muscle torch, but a direct ophthalmoscope is just as good. The next step is to test each pupil individually. This is not part of the RAPD testing, but is important because it gives you information about the reactivity of each pupil. Hold the torch 10 to 20 centimeters away and shine the light directly into the unaffected eye first. Hold the light at that eye for 2 to 3 seconds and then swing it across and shine it directly into the other eye for the same length of time. Take care to illuminate each pupil for the same amount of time, as if you spend more time with the light on one pupil compared to the other, you can create an artifactual RAPD due to uneven bleaching of the photoreceptors. Make your judgment regarding the presence of an RAPD in 2 to 3 repetitions of light swinging. If you're still not sure after this, take the light away and let the patient's photoreceptors recover for a few seconds, then repeat the procedure. It is important to remember to hold the light directly in front of the eye with each swing and not to pivot it from the central point, as this results in uneven illumination of the retinas and may affect your results. When assessing pupillary reaction to light, the key is to look for an initial response, which should be a constriction, as well as a speed of dilation following that. Like many things in medicine, an RAPD can be of different severity. It can be generally classified as mild, moderate, or severe. In a mild RAPD, both pupils still constrict when tested individually. However, during the swinging flashlight test, when the light is shown into the affected pupil, the pupil will constrict to a lesser degree than the normal one. It will also have a slightly quicker release, that is, it will dilate faster. In a moderate RAPD, both pupils may still constrict when tested individually. However, during the swinging flashlight test, when the light is shown on the affected pupil, the first movement will not be a constriction, but it will either stay static or dilate. In a severe RAPD, the affected pupil will constrict significantly less than a normal one, or even not at all, when tested individually. However, during the swinging flashlight test, when the light is shown into the affected pupil, the first movement will be a profound dilation.